I have seen that man, and it is not a pretty sight. I'm very nervous. It's Capitano.
Yes,
well, my goodness,
my lady.
My goodness. Yes. Now, Capitano.
Yes.
Hello.
What can I do for you, my lady? I come from Spain.
Yes, you do. The
all
great
the way to see
Spania.
You.
Me.
Of course.
Me.
And you.
You came to see me.
And you. And you.
No, but me. And me. You. Me.
Well.
Nose back on me.
You first. Yes. Of course.
I've been dreaming of this moment for so long.
I have two for about the past 30 seconds.
Oh, I got 30! Last time it was 20! I'm so excited. Capitano, I have missed you so much.
And I have...
There are so many things I want to tell you about my dreams and our future together. And
future?
All the, yes, future! Because yes. You and I will get married in a church just like this one day.
Oh.
And we will have children and we will raise them to be an army of loving, talented people that will bring joy to the world. And you and me will do that.
Of course. What's that over there?
It's Megara.
Have you seen my master?
Oh, that Capitano's memento! He did it again, Pascuala! He left me again! Oh, it happens every time with him. He's very scared of commitment and really everything.
I prefer mysterious
fish. Pascuala, I know that Capitano doesn't treat you very well. But he doesn't treat any of us very well, really. It's horrible. Where have you been?
On a ship.
On a ship?
Yes.
Did you come all the way from Spain with him?
Sort of.
Oh, no.
The only way I could get on the ship was with the animals.
You traveled with the animals? Oh, my goodness. Oh, don't you know we have a show to do, Miss Quayla? You have to clean up. Oh, my gosh. Take a bath very quickly. Because you're important to the
bath?
Show. Yes, bath. Yes.
Water?
Yes, water.
No!
Oh, she's a darling, and she has some quirks. She's one of those extra characters that doesn't really have a, you know, a set discipline. You know, she's very creative, so she doesn't...
Quirks. I've heard of quirks.
Oh, dottore!
But not
dottore. Dottore Graziano, you are just the perfect man. You are exactly who I needed to see. I have a problem. I have a troupe of actors, and they do not have a contract yet. They show up, and they're volunteers, and I'm very grateful for that, but we don't have a contract. If one of them doesn't...
Known as party of the first part.
Yes, exactly, yes. If one of them doesn't show up for a show, then we have to find an understudy, and that's
understudy.
Really, really hard, unless you know all the right people in Meridier. So that's just really hard.
An understudy at the union rate?
Yes, union raves. Union.
Oh,
Razio! Oh,
yes,
I'm so glad you're here.
Show.
Oh, dottore, you write that contract up for me, please, please do that, and then I'll meet you later. Oh, Razio! Thank goodness you're here. You being the most handsome young man in all of Ravenna,
of course. You
have got to get married. To Isabella.
Absolutely. There is no one else in the world that I can love.
Did I hear someone say the most handsome man in Ravenna for me?
Oh, Isabella! Oh, yes! There you are. Here.
Of course. And you are Isabella.
Yes.
The most beautiful woman in all of Ravenna.
Oh, well, yes.
Whenever I see you two together, my heart flies.
Oh, to the sky, to the blue sky.
Yes. Where's your eyes?
Oh, it's such a wonderful thing to think of.
Married
to the most eligible and handsome and fine.
Exactly. And I'm sure your father will just love it. Your father will say this is the perfect
match. It's perfect.
And he'll pay for everything, including the honeymoon, where we go everywhere.
He'll pay for everything.
We'll
be perfectly happy that penniless little Orazio here is because it's your true love. He'll be perfectly happy.
Is Abdallah what are you doing?
Papa.
Oh, hello.
Olivia. Yes.
What are you doing hanging out with this riffraff?
It's not riffraff.
No. You're not getting married. No, Isabella. I will not allow you to marry just any man off the street.
But
from Meridier's, ah? Oh, no.
There's nothing wrong with Meridier's, Pantalone.
Is that just
you,
anybody?
Just, he's my true love.
Oh, where's the money?
Oh.
Where's the money? Go on, go. Back to your room. Oh, you, out of my house. Out of my house.
Now, Pantalone, I won't stand for it. This true love, you can't say no to true love.
Yes, I can. I can say no to anything. Except you. I can't say no to you.
No, you can't. No. We've been neighbors for too long.
Yes.
And you know, Pantalone, that my 27 husbands all died from natural causes.
All natural causes, yes.
Yes. You have nothing to fear.
I have nothing to fear.
Nothing at all.
So.
My herbs and spices cabinet has absolutely nothing to do with that dinner I invited you to tomorrow night.
Did you get dinner?
Yes, I did, Arlecchino.
I have to go make sure that my friend Dottore has given me all the right concoctions for tomorrow.
Yes.
So you will excuse me, I have to go supplement myself.
Did you say dinner? Because my master never feeds me anything.
Oh, that's horrible. Who's your master today,
Arlecchino?
Dottore is your master today. Well, he's always distracted by his books and his contracts.
Isn't, so I'm always going hungry.
But how he's distracted, can't you just go into the kitchen and eat something in the kitchen? He's in the library, you're in the kitchen.
Which way is the kitchen?
Oh, the kitchen is back there.
Oh, back there.
Yes, oh, come on, come on. He's so obedient. That's just wonderful. So my lords and ladies, you have met our characters, you have met the people of Ravenna, and you will experience soon a very period sort of old ancient method of entertainment. This is Commedia dell'arte, 16th century Italian comedy improvised theater. That's a lot, so if you didn't hear it improvised, we do not have a script. We, in fact, have a thin outline of a story. It is a story that you may have heard some pieces of before, but one of our dear friends, Lady Luceta di Cosimo from the troupe Genesiae up in Ethelmark, the grand and magnificent kingdom of Ethelmark, she wrote it, and then we are producing it, but it's nothing like she started with. Because when we improvise, we take the story and expand on it, and the characters go in different directions. And when you see the next show, they might be different.
Sophie, do you have my copy of the script, of the scenario?
No.
I can't find
it anywhere. I'm in the middle
of
a speech. I'm doing the educational portion. We are a 501c3 educational organization. We will go down. We will have to pay taxes if we don't prove that we're educating people.
It isn't one of these, is it?
No, it's not one of these. But, you know, here's the intro to Canadian handout. You're a Laurel. You know how to hand out handouts, right? You've done it once before.
All right, I'll do it.
You might want to do that. By the way, I brought documentation for this show. In fact, I brought documentation that you can yourself get. Go to sca.org and look at the publications. Go to Complete Anachronist and put in a little search term, Commedia, and these two will pop up. And this one was written by my good friend, Luceta di Cosimo. She's the one that wrote the scenario for today, and this one I wrote. So, all the documentation is right here. Everything you need to know about Commedia to get started, how to make it really happen, is in this one, 172. In this one, Luceta goes into great detail on characters and scenarios. So with these two, you have everything in your arsenal that you need to learn about Commedia and do it and bring it to life yourself. And they're only $4. So whenever you get the zin to do this yourself and say, that was so funny, oh my god, you're brilliant! You know how to keep people laughing. I want to do that when I go home. SCA.org, get the Complete Anachronists, number 172, 173, and you can do this yourself at home, and then give me a call, I'll help you out. There are so many things that you can do in Commedia because the characters are mix and match. We do not know what their relationships are gonna be show to show. We just know we have stock characters. And the men have masks, the women do not, because this was one of the times in history when women, for the first time ever, could go be on the stage and make a living at it. both those things meant that women were finally part of the theater community, and this started in Italy. It wasn't up to England yet. It took about 100 years for it to get there. I'm being educational! Jama, you know how important this is! She's learning something, you know? It's important for
learning. But the question is, are we allowed to be funny in this space? This is a church, after all.
Of course! I checked that out. And of course, yes, of course you can be funny in church, right? It's
excellent.
Of course. No one's gonna tell on us if we're funny in a church and didn't get permission for that.
You notice this is unlike everything else in this world, you can do this at home.
Oh, good. Maybe it's better to do it at home than in a church. Is that a problem? Am I supposed to? I'm sure everybody backstage is going to be perfectly organized and ready. They've all got their props and they've all got their costumes.
Yes.
What are we doing again?
You were on rehearsal. Gilbert, your mom brought you all the way here from Meridian.
I know.
We prepared you. We did all of that.
Thing was that I went to bed one night saying, sure, I'd help out, thinking I was going to be a stagehand. I woke up the next morning to find out I'm acting.
Yes, you're acting. Yes, you have the lead role. You are the lead male romantic lead. You're not a stagehand.
Does somebody have any rum?
No, drunk comedia is only funny for us.
Okay.
You don't want to do drunk comedia.
All right, okay. Rum after.
Get some black coffee backstage. Oh, my God. Look. We are going to be able to put on a very professional production because this is Kingdom Arts and Sciences Festival here in the Kingdom of Atlantia, and it will be absolutely perfect and well organized because these characters know how to stay organized and have everything set backstage. I'm certain of it. Now, if anybody backstage is not ready, then they need to do something to tell me that. Otherwise,
the Capitano Zora is ready.
Okay.
Benedetta has arranged for everyone to be ready.
Okay, good. That is really, really nice. So, my lords and ladies.
I found my scenario
for this. I
can't take any more of this. I need some sense of order.
I would like some Chinese dumplings.
So, my lords and ladies, we are going to get started. The story we are going to bring you today is one you have heard before. The story of Don Quixote, a man that originally was named Alejandro Quijano, and he went mad. He went insane after reading too many chivalric romances, and then he destroyed windmills, he traveled the world, and he sang a lot. And my lords and ladies, you do not know, but there is deeper truth to that story. That story is, in fact, one where our own Capitano, he knew what was happening, and he morphed and changed that man's life forever. And so we will tell you the story of Arlecchino of La Mancha!
Have you seen him? Have you seen him? He's over here. I know, I've seen him. Not funny. Not funny at all. Not funny at all. Okay. Let me tell you, when you run across the sea, all the way from La Mancha to Ravenna, it's a little tiring on the legs. That's true. True story, I promise. I run fast. Look, got to level with you all. Okay? Normally I'm not like this. Normally I'm composed and beautiful. Sit. But I am here because, long story short, I drove my neighbor crazy. It happens. My good friend, Alonzo Quijano, was my good neighbor. We drank. I told him stories about my chivalric feats, of course, about how I wrote a few books. You may have heard of him. One of them was The Nose That Lost a Thousand Sheeps.
Aww.
No? Yes? Shake your head. Yes. Thank you. The other one was The Nose. No bounce. The nose, no bounce. And the third one, of course, is you've had to have heard of it. The alternate facts of the Capifero. Nothing, really? That should have been impressive. Anyway, Alonso decided that he wanted to learn these things. Ah! Escuela, what are you doing here? I'm trying to lament with these people.
I follow my master everywhere.
I thought I left you in La Mancha.
Well, you tried.
Look, when Alonso came out and attacked me, I had to get away. I stole
his
armor.
After you hid under the bed for 3 days.
Well, it was a strategy. I wrote it down in the book. But look, I did not hide. It was a strategic retreat. I took his armor, and now I'm here in Ravenna, hopefully to sell his items. Because, you know...
Not the fish!
Of course the fish! You know... Do you know what he calls himself now? Anybody? No? No? I know you've heard of him. Don Quixote? Yeah? He attacked my windmills. Who would do that? Oh, Pasquale, what is that odor?
Well, when you went across the sea, I had to follow, and the only way I could follow was with the animals. They were nice. The pigs even shared.
I see they shared everything.
Well, it's close quarters.
Because you're in the trough.
No, I was in the bottom of the ship.
Oh, Pasquale, we...
So where are we?
I told you, we are in Ravenna. I'm hoping to look for Donna Olivia to hopefully sell these items. I hear she's coming to 20, 30, 40 small fortunes. I have to sell these magical artifacts. They gave Alonso, or I don't want to say his name, Don Quixote, amazing strength. He destroyed my windmill in one swing. With the move that I taught him, of course. But, alas.
I carried them for you?
No, it is okay.
It is I. Erazio of Ravenna. And I am in love. I'm in love more than anyone can be in love before. More than the air, more than the earth, more than the sky. I am in love. For the shoulders are beautiful, the chest is magnificent, the rump is perfect, the hands, oh, the hands. For the hands, they have the thumb, the index, the bird, the ring. You must always have the ring finger, the pinky. I didn't know there was another one. Well, anyway, and then the legs, the thighs, the knees, the feet, and the first toe, the second toe, the third toe, the fifth toe. 8 toes? Well, okay then. Well, you must love them all.
Of course.
Or I am in love. I am in love. Well, not with you. I'm not in love with you.
Wait. You do not love the Capitan?
No, I do not love the Capitan.
Oh.
Yeah, well, sorry, but you're not my type. You cannot handle what I can provide.
That is a lot of boasting for such a little scrawny man. I can handle anything you give out. What are you even doing here? And for you, do not love the Capitano. Everybody loves the Capitano.
I love Isabella. I love Isabella, the daughter of the richest man in Ravenna, Pantalone.
Ah, Pantalone. I've heard of this man before.
Yes. But I must find his house. I got lost.
I just so happen to know where Pantalone's house is.
Ah.
I am looking for Don Olivia. Would you happen to know this?
Yes. I know exactly where Don Olivia is.
Ah, well, that's Pantalone's house. That way.
And Don Olivia's is that way.
Ah, then we shall go. Could we see each other? Yes, wait. Yeah.
Wrong way. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sorry.
Pasquale, come.
Is I Pantalone, richest man in all Ravenna. And I, it is a wonderful day after. I have to get my daughter married. Finally, I have found a man that matches her. Oh, this is wonderful. I must tell her. Isabella, come out here. Don't sneak up on me.
I didn't sneak, you're just yelling again.
I have wonderful news for you, Isabella.
Oh, I love wonderful news, especially when it's me.
Yes. Yes, I have arranged for you to get married.
I've always wanted to get married! I'm so happy! Yes!
He is perfect for you. He is learned, he is smart, he is vetted, he is an established member of the community.
Well,
he is perfect!
I don't know about all that. I mean, I only just met him in the market yesterday, but he does write the best poetry, and he's so handsome, and oh, he's just the love of my life!
I am so glad that you think Dottore is perfect for you, because I think he's perfect for you, too.
Dottore?
Dottore, yes, Dottore Graziano.
Yeah, you know,
you've known him since you were very small. He's one of my best friends.
Well, he was old when I was young, and he's cultured all right. Kind of like old cheese is cultured, and stinky, and crumbly, and his skin flakes off, and he... Oh, please, no, Papa, not Dottore.
Yes, you will marry Dottore.
Please, not Dottore, Mama, please!
Not the money pouch. Isabella, this is...
Oh, no!
Benedetta, can't you do something with this?
Oh, no!
Go get ready for your wedding.
Cantone, what are you thinking? He is so old. When she is in the prime of her life, he will be dead. Who will take care of her?
Well, she will have money, and that's what's important. After all, money is the most important thing, for with money you can buy just about anything, as I have kind of guessed. It is wonderful.
So, are you selling your daughter?
I wouldn't say selling her. I mean, Dottore and I have an arrangement where he gives me the money, and then I give it back to him as the dowry, and it just works out that, you know, he gets his money back, and I get my money, and
I
get to keep my money, and...
It's always about money, isn't it, Cantone?
Yeah, yes.
Always about the money. So what is so wrong with him that no one will accept him without him paying for a bride instead of expecting a dowry? Oh, I know, it must be the alchemy experiments.
The alchemy experiments, he does do them, and every once in a while it does reflect upon him. He's gotten burned rather regularly, actually. But you know, it goes away.
On your daughter?
Oh, he told me he wouldn't be doing it on her very often.
Oh, well, that makes it all fine then, doesn't
yes,
it?
Yes, well, you know, I had this arrangement, and I got it okayed. That is to say that my friend Cosimo thought that this was a perfect arrangement.
Cosimo?
Yes, my friend Cosimo.
And have I met Cosimo?
I'm sure you've seen him around. Oh, up here he is right now. My friend Cosimo, he's been with me much of my life. Oh, yes. What is that, Cosimo? Yes. Tell her that it's a good arrangement and Dottore approves of it and has written the contract. Oh, yes. But that's just the way he says that it's the right thing to do.
Uh-huh. And you're listening to a coin.
He's my good friend. No, he's not just any coin. He's Cosimo the First, but Cosimo the Magnificent. You know, he's a de' Medici. You always listen to the de' Medici.
And he knows what's good for your precious only daughter, does he?
Well, he's given me advice, and I think it's good advice. Now, you go tend your mistress. She needs help getting ready for the wedding.
I will get her ready to be married, but not to Dottore.
Oh, Cosimo, what am I supposed to do? Here I am. I could have had sons. If I had sons, I would have been able to cavort with them and sit down, and it would have been wonderful. You know, I could have taught them how to make money and not spend money and, you know, lie, cheat, and steal. You know, the art of the deal, you know, of course. But no, I had to have a daughter. And a daughter that all she does is spend money. Oh, new shoes, new dresses. Dottore, my good friend, have I got news for you.
My good friend, you are my most loyal client. I have written for you all your contracts. I've done all your tax returns.
And a fine man you are.
Of course. And I await grand and great news because I am the happiest man in all Ravenna because I anticipate the most romantic marriage of all time. And I have done my preparation for the honeymoon.
Ah, yes.
All
yes,
those
the
libraries of Europe we will travel to.
Libraries. I get to.
Yes, libraries. You know, everyone loves the smell of old books.
They make me sneeze.
Yes, we'll go to the library of Alexandria. There'll be plenty there time spent with old books.
Didn't that burn?
Oh, I know. Did I read that? No, you can't possibly be right. But then, you know, of course, we'll be in all the finest places of Europe. We'll visit all those places like Roquefort.
Roquefort?
Yes, the cheeses of Roquefort. Oh, oh, the smell of cheese. Oh, yes. And, you know, cheese pairs with wine, doesn't it?
Yes.
And
yes.
Then we'll go to Stilton. Yes, we'll get some Stilton. And then, not to mention Limburger, most of all.
Oh,
we'll stop at Limburger.
I can't abide Limburger. I have to stay definitely upwind of Limburger.
But a honeymoon is not complete unless we go for a boat ride. And I have contracted. I had the chance to communicate with the first mate.
First mate?
Yes, the first mate. He's brave and true. That's right. He's very reliable, and he told me of his skipper, who is equally a famous seaman and that sort of thing. And they have a nice little brief boat ride around the Greek islands that we will contract. You know what? I must remind you that not only is it good for me to marry, but it's good for you to marry. It's not good to be a widower, and it's not good to be single. Because just imagine, something goes wrong in town, and what do your neighbors say? They say, oh, he was so quiet and lives to himself.
But how am I supposed to get? Well, there is Don
Olivia. Oh, yes, Don Olivia, a very good candidate. But yes. We're now concentrating on Don Olivia, or on you. We are concentrating on my good news.
Oh, of course, of course.
Yes. So about the boat trip.
Yes.
Because no honeymoon is not incomplete. No honeymoon is incomplete without a boat trip. And there's plenty of room. Yes. And that's why I brought it up to you before. There's plenty of room for five people. You know, a millionaire.
Wow, that's
right.
Oh.
At a party. Yes.
Yes, that's all right.
And a very ginger and happy Isabella, and of course her handmaid Benedetta.
Yes, yes, yes. And how long will this tour be?
It'll be a 3-hour tour.
I see. But there is one thing I need to tell you, Dottore. I told Isabella, and she was about the marriage, and she was very emotional. She broke down in tears.
Oh, of course, it's such a happy occasion. I can anticipate that. I've read all the romances. I've done my preparation. I've done plenty of preparation.
Yes,
yes.
But the problem is that it was not tears of happiness. Ooh. She said that you were old and you smelled like cheese and your skin flaked off and she was very...
I've got a remedy for that.
You've got a remedy for that? Oh, that's good. Because I don't think she was very unenthusiastic about marrying you. You don't happen to have one of those old chemical mixtures.
Oh yes, I
could to give her to her to change her mind.
Well, you know, she may think I am old and boring, but I can excite her. I swear, I can excite her. That's right. I have consulted the books of Pfizer and Bayer and Glaxo. Uh-huh. And that sort of thing. And my alchemical friends have recommended a recipe which I've made in a large batch.
Oh yes, yes.
And it works wonders because it changes.
A blue bottle.
So much so that you will not recognize me. But be careful, you only need this much.
Oh.
The little blue vial may not be right for everyone. Ask your barber if you are healthy enough to play at barley bread. In the event the effects of the potion last more than 4 hours, you should seek immediate high urgent attention.
not responsible for loss of limbs or appendages. Your results may vary. And we heard, Your Majesty, you could be losing your cool. This is no one.
No! So you say I won't even recognize you?
You will not recognize me, and you'll be so pleased at its performance that, in fact, we can make this in large quantities and ship it out and make all kinds of money. I've got the patent ready to write to get it.
Right, let us go discuss that.
Sure, you're good about marketing.
Yes, yes, marketing is my specialty.
I love Ravenna. Ravenna in the summertime is my favorite place. It's a wonderful time to get married and then see him die and inherit everything. Yes, I have been married 27 times. How often have you been married? How? Just once! Oh! Just once! That's not enough! Not enough for a woman of your beauty and magnificence. What about you? How many times? How many times? One? Just one? Oh, no. Oh, well, I'm so glad I'm here to show you how wonderful it can be. I'm Don Olivia, and I know how to make my way in the world. Yes, I have had 27 husbands, and I'm ready for 28. And I have my eyes set on Dottore Graziano. He's the only one in town that really has enough money to make it worthwhile, and yet also will bend to my will. So I need to find a way to make sure he understands who's in charge. Now, unfortunately, Pantalone is trying to marry off his little whippersnapper young daughter, Isabella. Don't you hate them? Ugh, it's just so annoying when the little young women get married off to all the men and then they take them all off. It's so annoying. So Pantalone thinks that he's going to marry off his best friend, Dottore Graziano, to his daughter Isabella. But I am not going to let that happen. No. Dottore Graziano, he will be mine. And I tell you, I have a plan in mind. I just need someone to come along and be a helper. So maybe a volunteer or a dupe, so to say. Maybe someone from not around here. Someone from a foreign country. Someone who's very biddable.
I will go to the highest bidder.
Well then, hello, monsieur.
I have been waiting to introduce myself. My name is Capitano. Alberto, Belto, Carlos, Diego, Eduardo, Felipe, Guillermo, Hector, Ignacio, William Thomas.
William Thomas?
Yes, William Thomas. That is a common name where I am from.
Of course it is.
Oh, you are looking beautiful, my lady.
Well, thank you. And who have you brought with you today?
This is my servant, Pasquela. She's a little, just don't.
Why don't you just stay up in there? Upwind. That's good. Thank you. So, Capitano, what brings you to our fine city of Ravenna?
Well, I was hoping to possibly woo you, my lady.
Me? No. I'm just an old widow. You don't need anything to do with me.
That is the second time today. Seriously, this never happens, ever. Well, I know you have had some bad luck in the past with husbands.
Oh, bad luck. Maybe. 27 times bad luck.
27 times. Well, let me show you these things. These are magical items.
Well, I can feel the magic emanating off of them. My goodness, where did you get them?
I got these from the legendary Don Quixote.
Don Quixote, I've heard of him. Is he mad?
Oh, a raving lunatic.
Raving lunatic?
He destroyed everything.
Pasquale, why would you want these things around if they're destructive magic?
Oh, well, these things will not only help you destroy your enemies, but they will also help build your empire.
Oh, destroy enemies, build empire?
Yes,
I think she might be interested in that. She's a conquering queen.
There is a silent bid going on right now. I'll make sure to put them out there for you.
I have the perfect person. My neighbor, Pantalone. He might even outbid a queen. Maybe.
I know, she looks powerful and rich.
Quite. Look at that crown.
Beautiful. No, but that's silver.
I thought that was white wool.
No.
No, I think Pantalone is a much better person. to market these unique magical items to. In fact, Pantalone has more than that to offer you. He has a daughter.
Ooh.
Yes, he has a young daughter of marriageable age. And he is looking for someone to marry her, and you would be perfect.
Is she quiet?
She's quiet and biddable. She never shrieks or anything.
Uh-huh.
And she will bring you much happiness forever and ever.
Does she spend a lot of money?
No, she doesn't spend money at all. She stays at home, and she does that thing. What's that thing with the needle and the thread? What is some of the word? Needlework! Yes, she does the needlework, and she will do everything that you ask.
She sounds like the perfect woman for the capitano, no?
She is! Let me write you a letter of introduction, and we'll get this started.
Oh, how could Papa do this to me? Married to Tor? I mean, he did this to the queen. I mean, set me up with this horrible, stinky cheese man.
I know, my lady. It's a terrible thing. We will sort it out. We will convince Pantalone.
My master, Dottore, has given me an errand. I can be helpful. He sent me to Pantalone's house. Do you know who lives at Pantalone's house? Who works at Pantalone's house? Benedetta works there. She is the most amazing cook. I mean, she makes these tortellini that are like just magic, just absolutely dark. Oh, Queen Nesca, it's so fabulous.
Thank you. So, you came here very excited today. What brings you to visit us?
Is that Tori here?
Cheese. And burger cheese.
Oh!
Anyone like cheese for sale? Cheese! I'm selling burger cheese.
I don't have any money, but...
Benedetta,
you could use that in food. Tori wants me to make sure that you're going to cook for the wedding feast.
I will indeed cook the wedding feast.
That's wonderful.
Let me think about that. We'll have the finest sausages in all of Ravenna from Baron Blix's Yes. Of course. Is there any other place to get sausages? No, there is not. And let's see, what else do you think should be on the menu?
That really good mascara or something.
Oh,
and there's the yogurt.
Oh, the yogurt. Yes. Okay. I think we're going to have a full spread here. That's awesome.
Awesome. I'll go call him.
You may want to tell him about the feast, but there might be a few issues with the invitation list. Like, he might not be on it. So,
well, I'll be sure to let him figure that part out.
Yes, we leave that to the richest men.
Awesome.
And...
is that Tori back? What is that smell? Oh!
What is that?
I have General. A
oh. Who are you?
I'm Pasquela. And I have a letter. It's from Pantalone.
Oh!
Okay.
What kind of you?
Hand me the letter. I'm not, but I read all of his mail in case it is a tax letter and he would have a heart attack. So, I can in fact read, yes. I read all of his mail, I manage all of the household accounts. Give me the letter, yes. Yes. Thank you.
Yes.
Go.
I'll find my master.
Yes.
Thank you.
That's... Whew. Wow! I can't take any more of that.
Okay.
Odiferous.
Yes.
Yes, okay.
So, let us read what this is.
Young?
Oh.
Eligible?
Virile?
Handsome?
This must be the letter introduction.
Oh! Oh, maybe! Maybe time!
Yes. It has to be about Orazio.
It is I, Orazio! And I am in love. I am in love. I am in love with you, Isabella.
Orazio!
Marry me!
Absolutely! Of course!
Yes.
What
is going on out here? What?
Well, Pantalone!
this letter
of introduction. Oh, it's not a taxes.
No taxes. Just a social letter of introduction for Isabella's future husband.
Yes.
Oh, this must be Dottore after the potion. Let me take a look. Look at those shoulders.
Yes.
And the arm. And the hand. Oh, he's got five fingers. Dottore, this really, really worked. You're gonna have to get me some too.
Of course.
Isabella, yes, I bless this marriage. You two should get married. Why don't you go discuss the plans for the wedding?
Yes. Let us go and pretend to be married.
Of course. I'm not without your chaperone, young lady.
Yes, not too early. Oh, whew, that boy. Did that potion work well? It's Dawn Olivia. I just love Dawn Olivia. Hello, Dawn Olivia.
Hello, Pantalone. It's lovely to see you.
Yes, and what can I do for you today?
Pantalone, I have someone for you to meet.
You do?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sure I will really enjoy it.
You remember we've been neighbors for many years.
Yes.
And you've seen me marry all 27 of my husbands.
Yes.
And we've cried together at all their funerals.
Yes, and I wish you would take advantage of my offers to merge our households.
Oh, I'm not worthy of you, Pantalone. No. No, I have someone else. That's going to be perfect for your family. Stand right there.
Oh, this is great. I just love everything that...
Capitano! And some other names, Spavento.
Meet
Pantalone. I'm sure you know who this is. He's amazing. He is the new husband for your daughter.
It is good to see you.
It is. Benedetta! Isabella, get out here!
Yes, Papa! Yes!
You brought this interloper into my house! Get him out!
No!
It is. I take back what I said. You are not to marry my daughter.
No!
Isabella, you shall marry this man. Oh. My decision is final.
Yes! First, we have the shield of Saint Sebastian.
will block 12 arrows every time. Watch out for number 13, lift the leg. Okay?
Not like the ones you see on eBay.
Would you like to hold?
Yes.
It is beautiful, no?
Ooh. Oh, this is it.
Okay,
this
enough.
Is
enough.
It.
Enough. This is my next.
And what have we next?
We have the grenade of St. Scholes. Also up for bid if anybody would like to buy. Smells beautiful. Awesome. You have problems. Don't pull! Do not pull! You trying to kill the queen? Treason.
It looks so authentic.
It is authentic.
Of course it's authentic.
It is a one-of-a-kind item. Next, of course. I'm sure you know exactly what this is.
The golden helmet of Mambrino.
The golden helmet of Mambrino. White gold, of course. Not
because it doesn't translate too well in, from language to language.
Please kneel, and I shall show you the knowledge that this provides. You are now...
I am invincible!
Not anymore. And finally, last but not least, the fish of our knowledge. Yes. So much power. I feel the power. Don't yank.
Don't yank?
Do not yank. He does not like that. This is it. What if a kind of island and you're playing with it like a normal fish? I will tell you of these things. Please?
What are you two new scouts doing here? Get out of my house!
I can tell you my story is a design.
Everybody is mad at me. Dottore's mad at me because I can't control Isabella. Isabella's mad at me because I can't get him to marry him.
Signora Patrona, I'm here to talk to you about the wedding.
Arlecchino, the marriage to Dottore and Isabella is off.
No, not that marriage, Signora Pantalone. I want to ask the hand of Benedetta.
Why would you want her?
Have you tasted her linguine?
It's good, but it's linguine. Arlecchino, get out of my house.
Oh.
Now even Arlecchino is mad at me.
Well, of course we're all mad at you, Signore. You're a terrible person.
And your point?
Well, nobody's gonna like you. Not until you're dead and they have to, like, try to write a eulogy or something.
Wait, say that again.
People will say nice things about you when you die. Until then, you're stuck with the truth.
Arlecchino, you're a genius! How did you come up with this? Excuse me, I'm going this way.
I'm just gonna write some poetry. Maybe it'll calm me down.
Think of your true love. Write some poetry.
Yes.
It will make you calm and centered, my lady.
Maybe I'll write this one.
You had started some, I know. There were quite a few letters. Thank you. Hi, Arlecchino. Down. There we go. Good boy. Very good. Who's a good boy? Oh, yes. Oh, so good. Thank you. So, do you know, it occurs to me.
Yes.
Arlecchino, you like to be helpful, don't you? Yes, right? You like to make me happy? Okay, so here is something we can do. Do you remember when you were coming here to talk about the feast, right? It's always about food. And there was that smelly lady who came bearing the letter of introduction.
The fish lady, yes.
The fish lady.
Yes. That's a smell.
I remember that.
The fish lady. Right. So she was bearing a letter of introduction to Roxio, so clearly she must know how to get a letter back to him.
She must know how. Yes, of
right?
course.
Yes.
How did I not see that?
Yes. So, your true love. You must express your true love.
I must.
In a letter
yes.
to him.
Yes.
So, wait. Good. Wait.
Okay.
I started with that one.
We did start with this
we
one.
Did start
okay,
with
so
this one.
So this one talking about oh, the heart that you drew on this one is lovely.
But this one's kind of smudged. It won't work.
All right. Pull that aside.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Okay. I wrote this one when I was thinking about how his eyes look like the water of the fountain, and they sparkle almost as much as mine, and...
Oh, that's good. That's good. Hold this, too. Hold this, too. No, but there's this lovely section in here about the haven of his arms that you want.
Yeah, that's good.
Right? And I think that's a good snippet. So more. So hold this.
Let's see. I put hearts over all the eyes in this one. I did. I think it's trendy. I think it'll catch on.
Okay.
I think it's good. Yeah. So maybe that one?
Maybe this one, yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. Maybe this. We might need to, yes.
Oh, take,
well, we're not losing anything, but I think we need to pluck the very best parts of each of these and put them into one letter that is less stained by your tears, my lady, so we can read it.
Even though they're the tears of my love?
You can cry on it, so we'll leave a section on the bottom for you to cry on.
Oh, that's perfect.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
All right, come with us, Arlecchino. We're going to write a fresh letter
yes.
for her to deliver.
Oh,
for
yes.
For
happy
us.
Day.
Johan, you're going to be playing the intermezzo for us, correct?
I am.
And the intermezzo is an Italian word that means something...
A gap.
A gap. In the middle.
Yes.
A middle something gap. Well, I'm a little concerned about something. I'm concerned that they're not going to be able to hear you. That thing's not very loud, Johan. It's not. I mean, I've heard you, and you're working on it, and your projection's pretty good, but they're not going to be able to hear you in the back. We have to fix that.
How so?
We need to encourage these bodies to raise themselves up off of the chairs that they're in and move to the forward benches. And so everybody that's in the back there coming forward is going to be very important for the last scene. It's extremely important that you come forward and you're in the first two rows. So, you're not going to be able to hear him, and you're not going to enjoy the last scene as much as possible if you're way back there where we can't see you. So come forward, everybody. Okay, the couple in the back is necking. But you can do that right up here, where we welcome it. We welcome your affection, public or not, right over here. Down here is where all the action is. It's very important, especially for the last scene. Because you don't want to miss the last scene. And, you know, your wife is sitting next to the queen, and this is good. You might be able to make that politically worth your time if you, like, have a political song. Do you have a political song?
I don't, but I have a song about cheese.
A song about cheese! Dottore's gonna love that! Oh, come on, forward, see? Mistress Helwyn here is by herself, and you know what happens when she's left alone. You know, she starts to become mischievous, and it's a little scary. You know, thank you for protecting us and saving us, because, you know, she's brilliant, and she starts to do crazy, mischievous things when she's there. All right, now, Johan, I understand that you've got a little stage fright.
Sometimes,
and you have worked through that.
Occasionally.
And so every once in a while, you do, you know, your good days and your bad days, but I'm going to help you out. We are going to make sure the audience knows how to applaud for you, so that no matter how well or bad you do, you will get the applause because they'll have the practice. Is that a thing?
Yes.
Yeah, I learned that in class. It was great. 501c3 educational organization over here. They're not clapping yet. I haven't given them the cue. All right, so audience, there is going to be times when you might want to applaud or laugh. And I would encourage you to do so very loudly, because they can't hear us out there and they don't know the fun we're having. So when you laugh loudly, as if I have said something really funny, then they will know that in fact this is where the fun is. See, they're figuring it out right now. They're looking, They're looking. Okay, so ready? You're gonna have to laugh really, really hard. They're just sort of temperate. Yeah, they're trepidatious over there. So I'm gonna count to three, all right? And then we're going to laugh really, really hard and loud and make lots of noise so that they know what we're doing. Okay, you ready with me? Okay, you know the 1, 2, 3 part? You ready? Okay, 1,
ha.
2, 3! Oh my God, that's wonderful! Ladies, you have a treat. For the intermezzo, we have Lord Johann von Solothurn, one of the most magnificent singers and instrumentalists we have in the entire kingdom. One round of applause for him.
Sophie asked me to sing a song about cheese, and I thought about this one. This is a, Martin said to his man, there's repetitions in there. Feel free to sing along if you like. This is a piece from 1609 by Ravenscroft. There might be an additional verse at the end, and I'm going to sing it anyway. It might not be period, but the rest of it's okay. Martin said to his man, fie, man, fie. Martin said to his man, who's the fool now? Martin said to his man, fill thou the cup and I the can. Thou hast well drunken, man, who's the fool now? I saw the man in the moon, by and by. I saw the man in the moon, who's the fool now? I saw the man in the moon, fixing St. Peter's shoe. Thou hast well drunken, man, who's the fool now? I saw the goose ring the hog, by and by. I saw the goose ring the hog, who's the fool now? Saw the goose ring the hog, saw the snail bite the dog. Thou hast well drunken, man, who's the fool now? I saw the mouse chase the cat, by and by. I saw the mouse chase the cat, who's the fool now? I saw the mouse chase the cat, saw the cheese eat the rat. Thou hast well drunken, man, who's the fool now? A tree, who's the fool now? I saw a flea heave a tree 20 miles out to the sea. Thou hast well drunken, man, who's the fool now? I saw a maid milk a bull, five and five. I saw a maid milk a bull, who's the fool now? I saw a maid milk a bull with every bull a bucket full. Thou hast well drunken, man, who's the fool now? Never mind.
And then they stop. And then, of course, there's this. How can you have to hold it with reverence? It's the hand grenade of Dr. Scholl's. Don't pull that!
Don't pull it. Don't pull it. Don't pull it. Yes, don't pull it. You never know what will happen.
And, of course,
the fish of knowledge.
Can I eat it?
Well, it is culinary, but you don't... just hold that. Yes.
Stop,
and then of course, the element of memory. Hold it.
Doctor, I must talk to you. I must talk to you right now. You must write what's that word? What is that? When somebody dies.
Be the death of you. Just calm down, calm down.
When somebody dies, write obituary. Oh, yes, that's it.
Obituary.
An obituary. You must write me an obituary.
Write you an obituary.
Yes, yes.
Ah, yes, I can consult all my literature. And it's a new language, I must admit. But tell me, what is the whole purpose of me writing a new obituary? Look at the presence of manhood among us.
When people think you're dead, they say nice things about you. So,
sir,
so you need to come. Come, quick, quick, quick. You must write me an obituary right away. Come.
Oh, you found him! You found him! I don't... What is this? Magically appeared! Meet me at the fountain. This must be from Isabella. Ah, she has finally come to her senses, and of course, as I knew she would. But this is going to be great. Wish me luck.
Oh, I'm so frustrated. Arlecchino, what are you doing here? He's disappeared. I need somebody to help me. Oh, look, littering in Ravenna. This just is ridiculous. How many people are just leaving their really desperate love letters? Oh, and it's got the little heart above the eye. This must be from Isabella. But she didn't sign it. She just said, the most beautiful woman in all of Ravenna. Ah! No. She is going to be the death of me. Oh! Dottore, I'm so glad to run into you.
Glad? I'm preoccupied. I'm sorry. I have the most unusual task.
Oh, share your burdens with me, Dottore. I'm here for you.
All right. I am required to write an obituary for Pantalone.
Pantalone?
How sad a task that is to do.
Yes, very sad.
Of all
so sad.
My friends, to me, to eulogize.
I didn't know he was on the edge.
Pantalone.
I would have married him first yesterday.
That is a task.
Dottore! Oh, how sad! Sad for you. I'm so sad for you. Yes. No. Oh, don't worry about that. That's just some litter I found. It's nothing. It's just Isabella writing things and leaving them on the street like a litter bug.
I think my fortunes have changed.
That's not addressed to you. Dottore, no, this is not. This is not addressed to you. She's
I've got
not
enough
saying
enough
you.
She's
the leader at the fountain.
Obituary to write.
Yes, write the obituary for poor Pantalone! Don't go to the fountain to meet Isabella. That's just that's a tryst. That's not something dignified people do. What if the queen found out? That's just Dottore. That girl, she is just causing.
There will be blood tonight.
But
I will kill
Rossio, I have news for you. It's really important. But I don't want you to get excited. You're talking about a battle. You don't need battle. It's not for you.
Yes.
You are a lover, not a fighter.
Yes, I am a fighter, and I know how to fight. There are rules to these things.
No, there aren't. It's war. It's bloodshed. It's chaos.
No, that's war. That's different. That's panic. There are rules to fighting.
There's rules.
Yes, there are rules, especially one-on-ones. I only have one, right? Yes, there's
one.
Only one. Yes, I'm one, and there's only one of the rivals after Isabella.
What?
No.
Orazio, you are in trouble because there are now three rivals for Isabella, and they're all going nuts. They all think that they're going to meet her by this fountain, and she put the little heart on the eye so you know.
Oh, great.
And then she
here
just
we go.
Leaves
no, I must fight them tonight, and I know how to fight. Yes.
You can fight.
Yes, of course I can
Orazio,
fight.
Look at this.
Look at
this.
I've seen fighters smaller than me. There are rules to these things. If you hit them in the head, they die. They fall over, they're dead. It's over. You hit them in the body, they die. They fall over, they're dead. It's over. You hit them between the knee and the thigh, they have to call good and they get down on their knees and you can hit them in the head like a tent peg over and over again. It's really easy.
How chivalrous.
Yes, I know. It's wonderful.
I'm so glad to know there's rules for these things.
Yes, and there are other safety rules.
Safety?
Yes,
in
there
war.
Are safety rules, of course.
For fighting?
Of course, yes.
But then how do you kill anybody?
Because you just keep hitting them. It's Atlantia, after all. You just gotta hit them harder, even when they fall over. You just gotta keep hitting them harder and harder and harder until they yield. Yes, and if they fall a hole, everybody stops and they look around to find out what's going on.
Oh, well. Well, I'll just call hold then and tell them
yes.
To stop
well,
fighting.
Well, I have to go and fix my armor. I'll be back.
No, you don't fix your armor. Oh, I'm always gonna
that, that man has the best idea. I can go fight people for the love of Benedetta.
Oh, Arlecchino, not you too. No, no, you can't have all this fighting in the street.
But,
no, it's just way too Shakespearean, and that's later.
Benedetta.
Okay, Arlecchino? Yes, yes, Arlecchino, you should go fight. Yes, but you must be prepared. And in fact, you are so lucky. You have those magic artifacts from Capitano. You have the shield of Saint Sebastian. You have the fish of all knowledge. And this fish is not just smart. This is your swordfish. And you have the grenade of Saint Shoals.
Oh, yes, yes, I pull here.
No, don't pull it. Not until they're ready to die. And listen. Oh.
Is that why you need them, of course, for the last
time? Shh. This is, in fact, the most magical of all. This is the golden helmet of Mambrino.
The helmet of Arlecchino? It's for me?
We would all have it and we would use it for everything.
Well, you'd get rich inventing something like that.
I know, it's kind of sticky, probably water resistant. It's great for resisting blood and it holds everything together.
What an amazing idea!
I know.
You should market that. Go tell me it's lying.
No.
No! No, Orazio, I have to tell you.
What?
Pantalone is dead!
Woohoo!
Yes, exactly! Please. Let's go get you married to Isabella right now!
Yes! The fountain, Isabella, will be here any minute.
Wait.
Oh, your hands are so large. You are so beautiful.
What are you doing in my place?
I've been instructed to come to this very spot.
I have been instructed to come to this very spot. And I'm like, what are you doing here? I'm supposed to meet my love,
Isabella.
What do you know about romance? I've read all the romances. I've had Arlecchino.
For when we I'd like to be with you again!
There's royalty of the witches.
Oh,
yes.
Oh,
yes.
Yes. Your Majesty, I would never go against law. Of course,
because
of course.
Because it could also cost you.
Yeah, yes, right.
Yes, it's right here in the party of first part, the part, all here to around. Yes. Part,
the
first part,
the
second part.
Ooh. Thank you, Dr. Rayford.
There's a lot of parties in this.
Just one wedding party, right? Right. All the things that you said, so that I don't get thrown in dungeons and find all of my money, and we will leave things the way you said them. And you and Oregano, I mean Orazio here, get there. Yes, yes.
It does smell a little,
Yeah. So let us go, and we will work on the contract,
I'll get
sued.
I love a happy ending.
What am I to do?
So, my tell me over. About those windmills, you fine hunk of man.
Well, they definitely aren't able to stop something like that. What a woman!
Everyone's so happy, Dottore. And Isabella, she just didn't have what you need in a woman. And a wife. Why, if I were to write a letter and leave it on the ground for my lover to see, I would say something like, "You are my sun, my moon, my starlit sky. Without you, I dwell in darkness."
Ooh, very literary.
Yes. Dottore, you don't need that silly old book. I've got a complete anathemist at home you can read. About 40 minutes. So thank you, everybody, and have a great day.